Smith, where were you born?
Fifield, near Letchland. I was born in 1880, on the 12th of February.
I believe you spent nearly all your life with sheep.
Yes, all my life. Yes, more or less then.
Did you start work at a very early age?
13. The very day I was 13, I went to a place called Tom Jolly's to help fetch the second lot of sheep to the ewe pen. And then I started work amongst the sheep, all cuts of sheep, in the lambing pen. And I was at it all my life. And up for about 47 years, I never done anything else but sheep. My father was a shepherd, all a sheep. And he done nearly 70 years, and that was all cuts of sheep.
Did you enjoy your life as a shepherd?
Oh, yes. Very well. I done a lot of showing, you know, in days gone by. I went from the cuts of sheep to the Oxford Down sheep. I went to live at Langford in Oxfordshire just a while. And I used to go, so I went to the Royal Show at Bristol. I was at the Royal Show at Shrewsbury. I was at the Oxford County Show at Bicester. I was at the Oxford County Show at Wallingford. And around several shows I was around, and I used to take sheep as far as Yorkshire to sell them up at Driffield in Yorkshire, and Malton in Yorkshire.
Did you enjoy the solitude of a shepherd's life?
Oh, yes. You know, we had ups and downs, as we call it, but as a rule, I liked the shepherding, you see, yes, in days gone by. I was one of those chaps, as happened to drop in, I generally had the sole charge, and that was it. Didn't have anyone to bother me very much.
During lambing time, did you live out in the shepherd's hut for a time?
Mostly. Since I've been here at Longtree, I've done more at it that way. When I was a lad, my brother was looked after what we call the rams, shearling rams. He used to take 6 wagons, 36 sheep. There was 8 with horses and 2 with the sheep, and go the 13 miles. We used to get up in the middle of the night and go to Cirencester at the 13 miles and manage to get back at 8 at night. Leave at 1 in the morning and back at 8 at night. And, they used to think a wonderful average then if you get £11 each for them then, you see. Yeah. Some may up for 50 guineas like that. Yeah.
Well, you obviously spent much of your life out of doors alone. Could you tell what the weather was going to be?
Well, if it went round in the morning and you found all the sheep let down, you could almost guarantee you were going to have a fine day. And if you went along and see them jumping about or wandering about, you could almost say, well, you're going to have it very wet today.
You must have loved your sheep. Did you know them individually?
Oh, mostly. I think I could tell, I could walk, if one got out of one lot into the other, I'd tell you the one that's got out from there, I think, yes, when I was regularly with them.
What breed of sheep did you like best?
Well, Cotswold and Oxford.
But you will always have lived in the country. Do you ever feel you would like to have lived in a town?
Oh, no town for me. Let me, I'll Longtree with these 2 cottages. Does me a treat.
You love country life, do you?
Oh, loves country life, yes. It's wonderful, isn't it?
What gives you the greatest pleasure in life?
Well, I think to get out round and have a look at the whole country round about, you know.
When you were young, how did you used to amuse yourself in your leisure time?
Well, that was a strange thing. We pick a few chestnuts off of the tree, or fell down off of its tree. Because I was a little hamlet, about 22 where I was born. I walked over a mile to school. We could get a make-believe we got sheep, or go get in the farmyard and get in the carts, think we was driving the horses and so forth. Used to keep about 18 horses in the stable, and there was 18 bullocks. I drove the bullocks a little bit in my holidays when I was, last year I was at school. Yes, I loved the horses. They was wonderful things. I think you would be interested to see, there was little hills come down my own, see them coming home at night. There were 6 threes of horses coming down. That was 12 with them, men and boys. They come down, and then there were three teams of bullocks following down, like regiments of soldiers coming down off the hill, you know. Oh, you think that was wonderful to go along and see all the other chaps out in the field. There was a plough, and the ploughs squeak, and the chaps were whistling. Well, what was nicer than that? Here in the morning.
Looking back to some of the hard weather during your years of shepherding, can you remember a winter any worse than 1963?
I think I can remember quite as bad. I remember my father being out at night, my sister, youngest sister, she was home, and Dad was in the pen, and he'd been snowing and freezing and all, and he left his beard, you know. And he thought, well, I must go home now a bit. And he thought, well, he never took a lantern or stick or nothing, my father didn't. And he would come outside, and what he never knew before, there was his old dog led there. He'd just see it, and it was terrible dark, and the snow and all flying, and he had to go across a little field to get home by some trees. The wind comes so strong and nearly knocked him down. And he thought, well, I don't know where I am now. And he seemed to come over dark, and he looked down, there was the old dog down in the snow, and he jumped in front of him and led him home. And when he got home, my sister had to get told and that to thaw his beard and that, you know. So you see, there was rough days and days, those days.